So when you think of conventional manufacturing, you think of starting with a block of material, and then you cut and remove things from that block of material. Additive manufacturing works in the reverse. It lays material down layer by layer to create your final configuration.
A lot of people don't know what additive manufacturing is, but a lot of people do know what 3D printing is.
You add material from the base up, usually in a layer by layer fashion. You can use it on different types of materials, everything from metals to polymers, even electronics.
So a laser powder bed fusion machine uses the laser energy to solidify layers of metal that are only the height of a human hair.
And it'll repeat that process several thousand times till you come out with a finished product.
So there's a huge variety of parts that can be fabricated by additive manufacturing. Everything from small, non-critical pieces that are plastics, all the way up to these highly technical pieces.
Very complex designs that are almost impossible to make with conventional manufacturing. Sometimes they are impossible to make.
We can get higher stiffness but lower weight out of our parts. We can add more efficient cooling through internal channels, and we can also add dual functionality. So we can take what five parts used to do and put them down into one.
With a traditional manufacturing technology, it might take 12 weeks to get the very first sample, and it might take another 12 or 14 weeks to get the second sample. With additive manufacturing, we can spin those cycles of learning one right after another.
When a customer comes in and we're doing a proposal, we can slap a part right on the table and show them what their part would look like.
Additive manufacturing allows the designer to break all the rules of traditional design for manufacturing.
The hardware you're going to see come out of this company is going to look dramatically different. We're going to reduce our part sizes. I think you're going to see more organic types of shapes, honeycomb structures, lightweighting to get performance that we could have only imagined a few years ago.